for you. Nice find, the reverse dunk for two.
I'm glad to see that, you know, we're figuring it out together, and when we got it all right, it's just beautiful. You know?
Good for three. And turnaround jumper is good for Dominic Barlow.
There's Blake Wesley.
Wesley, get ready. What the thunderous dunk.
And like I said, he's got phenomenal defensive instincts.
Starting lineups for tonight's game, Malachi Branham, Devin Vassell in the backcourt with Julian Champagny, Jeremy Sochan, and Victor Wembanyama. Brogdon with the miss from the perimeter. Spurs on the break. Now Victor slows it up. Malachi will let it fly for three. Got it. And a spin here on Jeremy Grant. Drops it off. Victor underneath. Changing hands. Goes up and scores.
There you go.
Blazers sloppy with the basketball. Victor Wembanyama throws it down. As Malachi gets a step. Lays it up and in for two. Vassell. Wembanyama whips it around the horn, in the corner it goes, and the three-pointer is good for Malachi Branham. Trey Jones back to Victor Wembanyama, unloads on Jabari Walker. And Victor going up to get it from Devin Vassell and puts the exclamation point on this one tonight. A 30 spot for Victor Wembanyama to cap it off.
I think Malachi had a pretty good bounce back game after a rough one the other night.
No, he stayed resilient. He's making shots, making the right reads, and defensively, you know, he stepped up as well. So no, he did really well.
Just the maturation of consistency from all these young players. You know, it's hard to play every single night this week. You're asking him to make big time decisions and still be able to play and score and do some of the things he does so well naturally. So I think he's doing it. You know, happen every night, and it's good when he doesn't do it to then bounce back and do it the next night.
Of course, it's different and it's new. I'm ready to get any role and play any position. I love how we play. You know, how I can get to the opportunity also to share it to my teammates and be a central point in the offense. So the position really doesn't matter.
Thanks,
Dave. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you for y'all support. Go Spurs, go. We just got a good win tonight. You know, hopefully we can get one tomorrow.
Tune in.
I asked Malachi, you all split the two games at Portland 1-1, but there was a lot of positives from the win until y'all battled.
The good things that we did was just push the ball. You know, the pace was a lot faster, and our defense was very good. We were just trying to take step forwards, and I feel like you said, it was a step. Not a huge step, but like it was a mini step.
What do y'all take away going into tonight's game from that and moving forward?
I just think the energy that we play with in Portland, we have to just carry it over. Going into this game today, we want to win. We're going to play hard and see if we can win.
Yeah.
Branham, Trey, Sochan, back to Malachi. Just before the buzzer, Malachi hits the strings. Almost 5 minutes gone in the third. Wembanyama spots Malachi. Nice move by Malachi Branham. One off the back iron and off Horford into victory. He's ahead of the pack. He just puts it over to and he throws it down. With a bus,
he held it up there like he's playing against sixth graders.
The calendar flips from 2023 to 2024, and a fresh start for everyone, including the Spurs, who begin this portion of the schedule tonight in Memphis as they meet the Memphis Grizzlies. It's game one of the 2024 portion of the season. We've got all the action here on Bally Sports.
Yeah, I mean, if you're Taylor Jenkins, you want to get John Morant out in the open court, attacking as much as possible.
And that's Malachi Branham putting it up off the screen and roll for Victor. The Spurs are got to throw it up for a guy like Wemby as Devin throws it up again, and Victor over the top of Biombo.
Biombo might think twice before that one-man full-court press he was doing.
And Barlow. Keldon going to work on Vince Williams. That deflects right to Wemby. Four on the shot clock. Wesley's got a fire here. One to shoot in the paint. Pulls up. Got it.
Got lost in the rotation. We got to scramble out.
Nobody picks up Champagny on this set, and he makes the Grizzlies pay. Vassell lobbing it back to Champagny. Stripped of the basketball, and Morant hits the deck. Spurs still with it. Eight on the shot clock. A one-handed three by Victor. Off the backboard back. Wesley a step. Blake Wesley shows us his ups right there. Here come the Spurs. Vassell right to the hole. That's a floor. Drops it off to Wembanyama. It's a floor. It puts the hammer down with Marcus Smart on his backside underneath the basket.
We have to be sharper. We have to, make more free throws or make more shots. It was pretty good defense in a lot of ways. I'm pleased with their effort. They just have to keep the attitude up.
I really like what we've been doing in the first half. Our defensive rotations were pretty good. This is what we got to look like.
Blake and Bartle got 1 minute. What did you see from them?
Dom was much better overall than he was the first game when he got the minutes, for sure. And Blake's the same way. He looks more and more confident with the minutes that he's getting.
I'm proud of Blake. He's definitely trust the process. He brought a lot of energy tonight. I think this is just the beginning of a long, successful career for him. He brings the right attitude, plays with energy, plays hard. That's something that we need as a team.
Blake will play, yeah.
What have you made of Blake's minutes recently? It seems like he's been filtering in a little bit.
Yeah, I think he's done a good job. He's, he's played freely, and he doesn't look like he's worried about, making a mistake. He's been excellent at the defensive end, at the offensive end, just trying to figure it out with everybody else that he's playing with at the moment.
Good evening, everyone, from San Antonio, with one of the premier players in the NBA. Facing a celebrated rookie who has studied his every move.
And look at them guard one another. Trying to poke it away. Oh!
Wembanyama just put in his 10th. 12 for Middleton. Wembanyama. Oh, goes back!
Oh, no!
And puts it down!
Are you kidding me? Come on!
Jones to Sohan. With Portis defended. Inside, Wembanyama got it.
True closer on this team.
Lillard drives into Sohan. Wembanyama wipes it away with a rejection. It's Jones racing the other way. Vassell, Wembanyama three. Good! We are tied! Half minute to go.
Matheson help. There's no way that Jones is going to be able to guard him.
The screen, the drive. Oh, it's knocked away by Wembanyama! Knocked away by Wembanyama! Timeout, San Antonio!
Going back and forth with Giannis, bringing something out of you competitively. Did you feel how excited people were?
Of course.
You going back and forth?
Somebody I grew up watching and one of the greatest players in the world, so it's always extra motivation. And I'm a competitor, so I want to go at everyone.
He's special. There's gonna be extremely good player. Never seen anything like him. The sky's the limit, and as long as you work hard and you keep on having positive attitude and energy towards the game, everything that he dreams of is gonna happen for him.
Man, that last block kind of set it off for me. They were going back and forth all game, but, Big Show, the courage and heart that he had, because at the end of the day, Giannis, he wanted to try and dunk it at the end and send a statement. I think Big, sent a statement not only to Giannis, but to the whole league that, he's here and, he's ready for the moment.
I mean, just the fact that we can compete with a championship level team like this, it's promising. And it's also the first thing Pop told us coming back to the locker room, and I'm dedicated and I know at the end of the game, at the end of the day, I'm going to get what I deserve. And it's, every game is a statement for now.
Victor, as the Spurs come out of the timeout, it'll fall away for Victor, and he gets the rollover. Stepping away from Jeremy Sohan, Victor will bring down the rebound. Long lead pass, Sohan on the dime, and Jeremy throws it down. Wembanyama, Champagne for two more in the paint.
simple basketball. Set a pick, roll to the hoop, and finish.
And there's Tom Barlow and Trey Jones on the other end doing exactly the same thing.
You get a game.
You tell me what you get.
You get a game towel.
Wesley, and one.
Yeah, I mean, I think even these past couple games, we've just been playing better. Starting to play together as a team, starting to be connected on the offensive end, on the defensive end. Like you said, Wemby having a triple-double tonight was huge for us.
The bench was huge for us tonight. You know, from top to bottom, everybody that came in, brought a huge spark for us. Don played really well. Blake came in with a huge spark.
It took a little bit longer than we thought for everything to start clicking, but I think it's starting to click. And I think as fans and everybody who's watching, I think everybody's kind of starting to see it. So just excited now.
Johnson, back out. Branham for three. Got it. There's Barlow, 3:33 to go, first half. Vassell to the hole. Barlow says, I'll clean it up for you.
It looked like it was perfect timing.
Gives it off to Vassell.
There's another one.
Back to Wemby. Victor again. Oh, oh my goodness! Stop it! How? Yes, thank you for the timeout! Stop that! Sohan swings it. Devin does the same. Champagne. Gonna hit one as you do it.
Stafford, they're watching. There's Blake Wesley.
Wesley, get ready. What the?
We kept a good pace. We got it together as far as, you know, getting some buckets to go down. And I just thought that we were pretty solid at both ends of the floor tonight and had good performances by a good number of people.
We're a little ways into the season now. You spent a good little amount of time in the G's.
Yep.
Talking about your experience so far.
Nah, it's been great. Have to know some new guys, some new teammates are unbelievable. So they're great people. The coaching staff, amazing. I just got back from the showcase. We got two good wins for the first part of the season. It was great. We played good basketball. It's been good to be there out there in Austin to show some love to Austin too. It's amazing because almost every game is almost back there now, and I'm glad to be there for sure. So yeah.
I'd like to get him even more minutes, but I think he's got a lot of potential.
But now this year I look for a win and come back with a big team with the Spurs, try to figure out to be aggressive on defense, make the right play on offense, like I always do, play hard. And yeah, just to be always ready for with the big call, like we say. So
how's it been playing with Blake and Dom lately?
We got a good relationship, and yeah, we're brothers there, so we try to help each other there. We're winning some games too, so we good.
On the clock, half has come to a close. That is not a misprint.
Obviously, the starters needed some sort of a message or infusion.
He said we're being embarrassed, kind of. You know, this is also why he changed the starting lineup in the second half. He wanted to put players he could trust to be 100% on the court, and to kind of show us also the regular starters, you know, how we should have been, you know, starting the game.
But Pop decided to shake up the lineup and play the best five guys with the most energy for the second half.
I like it.
Pop.
I love it.
Love it.
That's why Pop is Pop, right?
Mm-hmm.
I thought the starting team in the third quarter made their point, and the first team came back and competed the way they're getting paid to compete.
Austin, triple, no. Trying to attack the glass. Spurs come up with it again. Champagne at three. Sohan cross court. Champagne with a three.
Okay, that's two threes here in this third.
4 minutes gone here in the third. Offensive rating number 27. That three will drop Champagne.
You want to get minutes on the court, you go play guard the best player, Blake Wesley. His defense is contagious right there. If you're watching, Trae Young has his full respect now. He's picking up full court. He's gaining Pop's trust. He's guarding. He's not worried about being embarrassed. He's not being cool. He's trying to stay on the floor and help his team win. He's doing a great job in this third quarter.
That's knocked away. Steal right there by the Spurs. Jones. Oh! He's got four.
Did he jump right there, fellas?
Nope. Champagne.
Peacheck.
How about the Spurs? Wembanyama from three, chunks him there.
No, he didn't.
Yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
23 leads the Spurs. 33 for Young. Turnover right there. Sohan goes by Young. And then Mama!
Sohan's been great at that high screen and roll here in this fourth quarter going downhill.
Sohan, and then
now I've got shooters in the corner and Devin Vassell and Keldon Johnson. Look at this. Oh, ain't no way.
He's got 22 points in 11 minutes.
The message, you know, was strong and obvious, you know, my pop. Tonight, a majority of bench players showed us how to do it in the second half, you know, and it worked. I appreciate also that he put Jeremy in, in the starting lineup. He's been bringing just the energy all game, you know, and he's been our example tonight.
You appreciate that kind of coaching. He's willing to sit you down. And
I like to be. I like to be coached. I like to be threatened and sent to the G League if I don't play the right way. I don't care. I like when there's consequences to my mistakes. You know.
How about Victor Wembanyama? His second half, didn't even start the second half of this game, scoreless in the first half on 0-4 shooting, and then goes for 26 in the second half on 12-14 shooting, had a couple of blocks, had 9 boards. What'd you make of what you saw from the big fellow there in the second?
It's super impressive. I like what Pop did. I've seen the kid message that, hey, in order to be great, you have to come out and play hard. You know, he probably thought he was playing hard, but every now and then when you're a big superstar, you need a person that you respect.
That was a move.
That you're not playing hard. So he came out second half and, you know, gave them, you know, a chance to win. And I think, you know, with all the hype behind his name, deservingly so, this is what we expect to see from this kid, 12 and 14. Me and Candace saw him do a move I've never seen before.
No rest for your road-weary Spurs. Right back on the hardwood tonight after a game last night in Charlotte. They've landed in our nation's capital. The Spurs taking on the Washington Wizards. It's game 4 of this 5-game trip. We've got all the action for you here on Bally Sports. Champagne for 3. Got it. Ackley trying to keep it active on the boards there. Instead, it's Wemby. Wemby throws the lob, and Jeremy throws the hammer down, and a timeout for the Wizards. Champagne with an opening, and rims out and rolls back in. Collins. Champagne. Nice. Left unattended. Continues moving to the basket, lays it up and in. Victor comes away with the ball there on the baseline.
Block too.
Vassell, Wembanyama in the paint, floating away from the bucket, and a timeout. Wes Unseld Jr. in the Victor pull up 3. Got it. Victor hits the strings, and we're tied at 121.
Yeah, well, you knew he was going to make that one.
Jeremy Sohan able to contest, and the Spurs have a win. 131-127, Spurs get the win here in D.C.
I'm so proud of him. I've known him for so long now. It always makes me feel good to see people I love make their dream come true. And it's just happening for him. It's going to happen for more young French basketball prospects. And it's just, I'm very grateful for this.
Good win on the road. You know, long trip, back-to-back on the road. Down 11, 5.5 to go. I got to really be happy for him. And, you know, it's a good example of that. It's a 48-minute game. You just keep playing. So.
Growing up in Europe, to gain your spot in a professional roster at 15 or 16, you got to play your ass off of defense. So it's, you know, going back to that role as a new guy in the league, it feels good in some way to have this tough role sometimes.